Hello students, I am Dr. Shivangi Dwivedi from Sagar Institute of Research and Technology, Bhopal. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic in communication skills subject, that is the process of communication. At first glance, the communication process seems simple enough, right? You say a few words to the interlocutor, they understand what do you mean, and give you a prompt response. But that's not always the way things go. Say that a joke you make falls flat, and you have to think of ways to redirect the conversation. Or you use the word bike to talk of your love of cycling, but the interlocutor thought of motorbikes. These issues occur because the communication process is ever-changing and depends on 8 interconnected factors. In the following sections, we'll devote more attention to the importance of communication process and each of its factors. To begin with, let's understand what is the communication process. Communication. By the word communication, we understand that communication is the art of transmitting information, ideas, thoughts from one individual or group to another. It constitutes reading, writing, speaking, and listening skills. Communication is a two-way process involving exchange of information between two entities. There is always a sender and a receiver in any communication. And the model of communication lays down the fundamental of the communication process. So, successful communication will always require both the sender and the receiver to share the responsibility in order to make the communication smooth, effective, and efficient. Now, let's start with the elements of communication. Communication process has some elements which we need to understand before understanding the process of communication. These elements are sender, encoding, message, channel, receiver, decoding, noise, and feedback. So, firstly, we'll start with the sender. Now, what do we understand by the word sender? Sender word depicts the source of communication. In the process of communication, the source or sender is the person who speaks in order to create and impart a specific message to their audience. The source may convey their message using verbal language, but also through their body language, clothing, and tone of voice. Second element of communication is encoding. Encoding is putting your thoughts or word messages into a language. Okay, now what do we understand by message? The message is source's purpose of communication. And during the communication process, the source converts this purpose into speech or text. Nowadays, a message can also be by using emojis, the addition of subheadings, adjustments in writing style, and formatting the message. Next element of communication is channel or medium. The channel is the manner by which the message travels from the source to the receiver. The examples of channels can be voice and video calls, direct messaging in business communication app, voice messages and emails, etc. The next element here can be receiver. As the name suggests, receiver is the person whose task is to receive the source's message. The receiver is just as important as the source in the communication process because their actions can make or break the interaction. No matter how carefully you choose your words, the communication situation may go awry, as you have no control over the interlocutor because He or she interprets the message, behaves after hearing the message, or uses their cultural experience and knowledge to participate in communication. And the next element of communication is feedback. Feedback is the response the receiver returns to the source. It may be unintentional or intentional. It can be nonverbal or verbal. Feedback is vital in letting the source know how the receiver has interpreted the message. Another important function of feedback in communication is to give the receiver a chance to request additional information or clarification, or support or object to the source's claims, and inform the source how to modify the approach. Next is the environment. Now, what is environment in terms of process of communication? Environment refers to the mental and physical context in which we communicate, both as the sender and the receiver of messages. It encompasses the setting, atmosphere, and conditions that may influence the interpretation and reception of information. For example, if you are in a conference room, your environment might include tables, chairs, laptops, windows, and/or a whiteboard. Psychological aspects of the environment may include whether the topic is discussed in a transparent manner and whether the communication is formal or informal. Another element in communication process is context. While some confuse context for the environment when talking about the communication process, context refers the scene or setting and expectation of the conversation participants. The most important process of communication has to understand noise. Now, what do we understand by the word noise? The final component of communication process is interference, which we also call sometimes as noise. Interference or noise can be anything that distorts or modifies the intended meaning of a message. If your desk is by the window, you likely see billboards and commuters and hear traffic sounds. This noise can halt your stream of thought or interrupt a conversation with coworkers. However, in the communication cycle, the noise could be psychological. Although you work in a quiet environment, your own thoughts could block you from fully listening to what someone is saying. For instance, if your superior hasn't finished talking to you, but you are already coming up with what to say in return, chances are you have missed a point. Similarly, if you forgot to drink water before joining a meeting, you may pay more attention to the water cooler than the presentation. So these kind of mental as well as physical barriers to communication are summarized in the word noise. Thank you so much, students, for your time. I hope this session is meaningful for you. Thank you once again.